स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम प्रोफेसर यस आर शिंदे फ्रॉम केकेवा कॉलेज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर बिजनेस मैनेजमेंट नाशिक. टुडे आई एम हियर विथ अ न्यू टॉपिक, दैट इज रोल ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स इन ऑर्गेनिक मैटर डिकम्पोजिशन. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट इज सॉइल ऑर्गेनिक मैटर? सॉइल ऑर्गेनिक मैटर कंटेंट इज जनरली कंसिडर्ड एज द इंडेक्स ऑफ सॉइल फर्टिलिटी एंड सस्टेनेबिलिटी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चरल सिस्टम्स. इट इंप्रूव्स द फिजिकल बायोलॉजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ सॉइल, protects soil surface from erosion and provides a reservoir of plant nutrients. There are different sources of soil organic matter that are primary sources and secondary sources. Primary sources we get from plant tissues and secondary sources are from animal products. Primary sources like top and roots of trees, shrubs, grasses, remains of harvested crops, soil organisms, etc. And secondary sources are waste products of animals and remains of animals after completion of their life cycle. In this diagram, we can see the composition of organic matter in plants. So, first part shows the water percentage in organic matter is about 75% and dry matter is about 25%. In case of elemental composition, here different elements are given with their composition. One by one, that are carbon about 42%, hydrogen and ash present about 8%, and oxygen about 42%. Different types of compounds are also given here, like cellulose 45%, fats and waxes with polyphenols are about 22%, and hemicellulose 18%, lignin 20%, protein about 8%, and sugars and starches are about 5%. Let's see the decomposition of organic matter and how different microorganisms play their role in decomposition process. So there are different steps under decomposition of organic matter. First step is decomposition of soluble substances. Under that, first process is ammonification. So some soluble nitrogenous compounds like amino acids, amides, ammonium compounds, nitrates, etc. are also attacked by different microorganisms, and when there is a transformation of organic nitrogenous compounds like proteins into ammonia occurs, that process is nothing but ammonification. So proteins converted into polypeptides, that polypeptides further converted into amino acids, and finally these amino acids are converted into ammonia or ammonium salts. In short, organic nitrogen is converted into ammonia, that is nothing but ammonification. So this ammonification occurs as a result of action of different enzymes which are produced by microorganisms, and this action is chiefly hydrolytic and oxidative. After ammonification, next process is nitrification. Nitrification is the conversion of ammonia to nitrite and then to nitrate. Nitrification is an aerobic process which involves the production of nitrates from ammonical salts. Here, ammonia is converted into nitrite by the action of nitrosomonas, and this nitrite further converted into nitrate by the action of nitrobacter. There is one more process, that is denitrification. In this process, conversion of soil nitrate into gaseous nitrogen or nitrous oxide takes place. So here nitrate is converted into nitrogen gas by the action of Pseudomonas or Bacillus bacteria. Second step under decomposition of organic matter is decomposition of some insoluble substances. So first is breakdown of protein. When proteins are complex organic substances and contains nitrogen, sulfur in addition to carbon, hydrogen and oxygen, when these proteins are goes on hydrolysis, that forms an intermediate products like proteases, ketones, peptides, etc. When these intermediate products further converted into amino acids or amides, and finally these amino acids and amides are converted into ammonia. So this is the simple procedure for breakdown of protein. Next is breakdown of cellulose. As cellulose is the most abundant carbohydrate present in plant residues, different microorganisms breaks up this cellulose into cellobios and glucose. Then the cellulose is further attacked by organisms and converted into different organic acids. Next is breakdown of hemicellulose. Hemicellulose, when subjected to microbial decomposition, first hydrolyzed to their component sugars and uronic acids. Then these sugars are further attacked by different microorganisms and they are converted into organic acids, alcohols, carbon dioxide and water. Hemicellulose decomposes faster than cellulose. Next is breakdown of starch. Chemically, starch is a glucose polymer and it's first hydrolyzed to maltose by the action of enzymes, that is amylase enzyme. Next, this maltose is converted into glucose by the action of maltase enzyme. So, glucose being soluble in water and it utilized for growth and other metabolic activities. Third step under decomposition of organic matter is decomposition of ether soluble substances. Here, fat is acts as a ether soluble substance. So, when these fats are first broken down by microorganisms through different agencies like enzymes, lipase, into glycerol and fatty acids. So, first product is glycerol. So, this glycerol further oxidized to organic acids, which along with other fatty acids are finally oxidized to carbon dioxide and water. Fourth step under decomposition of organic matter is decomposition of lignin. So, lignin is deposited on the cell wall to impart strength to the skeleton framework of plant. Lignin also decomposes slowly, much slower than cellulose. Here, different simple decomposition products are given with their nutrient elements. So, carbon, nitrogen, sulfur are here with their decomposition products like gaseous nitrogen, CO2, elemental carbon, etc. Which are the factors affecting decomposition? So, temperature, soil moisture, nutrients, soil pH, soil texture. These are different factors which affect the decomposition. So, let's see one by one. Temperature. In cold periods, which retards the plant growth and organic matter decomposition, whereas warmer climates accelerate the decomposition process. In case of soil moisture, both plant growth and organic matter decomposition requires moisture. Near or slightly wetter than field capacity moisture conditions are most favorable for both the processes. Nutrients. If there is lack of nutrients, particularly nitrogen, usually reduces the plant growth more than it slows decomposition because microorganisms use the nutrients in the dead organic material before plant root can be absorbed. In case of soil pH, most common microorganisms grow best under pH range 6 to 8 but are severely inhibited below pH 4.5 and above pH level 8.5. Soil texture. Soil higher in clays tends to retain larger amounts of humus, other conditions being equal. Most organic substances adsorb to mineral surfaces by many kind of bonds, particularly clays. So friends, in this video, we have discussed about soil organic matter, its decomposition and different factors affecting decomposition of soil organic matter. So I hope you like this video. Thank you.